killer changed his M.O., we know that.
And gave Cheryl a warning. Why didn't he warn his other victims?
I have no idea.
I have a theory. But I don't want to embarrass Cheryl.
What do you mean?
I think you should ask her.
Ask her what?
We've got to know if she's ever been with a guy before.
She hasn't.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm pretty positive. I mean, if she was going to be serious about somebody, it'd be about Scott. You saw him last night at Tops together.
That's why I think they've got to be a lot more careful. You have got to sit her down and have a talk with her.
You think the killer's going to come after her again?
I think the stalker is watching every move that she makes. Believe me, this is not the time for her to decide to go to bed with Scott.
Be right there.
Hi. I just went for a walk.
Why weren't you walking out here by yourself?
I didn't go very far. I had to do some thinking.
What were you thinking about?
Us. We've known each other for almost a year now.
Yeah?
And right. We've been through a lot together. I loved you, Scott, from the first time when I saw you, and I am so glad we're not fighting anymore because I couldn't stand being without you. When that killer came after me, I realize what is really important in life, and I made a decision.
Whoa. What kind of decision did you make?
I want to go away with you. I want to be with you, Wolf.
Well.
Yep.
Your friends are...
Well, my very dear friend.
Oh, Dr. Glazer.
Well, maybe he didn't come to see just me.
Dr. Glazer, I am so glad you're here. I really needed to talk to you in person.
The messenger said it was pretty urgent. I assume it's about the photograph of John and the baby.
Yes. I saw it again. Well, I confronted my father, and he showed it to me.
Oh, darling. That must have been very difficult for you.
It was. My father said that he knew about John and me from the beginning. Hmm? And that John Hudson really is the father of the twins.
Oh, come on. How does he know that's true? What kind of proof did he offer?
Blood tests. He said he had blood tests made.
Do you believe?
No, of course not. I think the picture's a fake, and I think he's lying about the blood test, but that's what I've got to be able to prove.
Well, that may not be so easy, though.
But I need your help.
Well, of course, I'll do whatever I can.
Oh, good. Because I have got to prove that Michael is the father of Victoria and Marley.
Well, what's up? You realize I was just on my way to pick you up?
Oh, really? Well, I just thought I would save you the trouble.
Well, thanks. I didn't interrupt anything, did I? No, we just happened to run into each other.
Yes, and I decided that I would try to make another appointment.
Oh. Well, I'll tell you what. Why don't you guys finish your conversation, and I'll go talk to Mitch, and then we'll go over to my mom's.
Okay? Good. Perfect.
Good to see you, Doc.
Good to see you.
I can't believe it. We're so close.
I assume you haven't spoken to Michael about this.
No, of course not. I'm not going to say anything until I know the truth.
I can only help you so far on that one.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, with blood type information, I can't tell you who the father is. I mean, I might be able to tell you who the father isn't.
Well, that's all I need to know.
Yeah, but the point is, what I'm trying to tell you is you may not be very happy with the results.
All I need to know is that John Hudson couldn't possibly be the father of my girls.
Okay, well, I'll have to know all the blood type information.
Well, all right. Well, Marley and Victoria are AB positive.
Yeah.
And I'm A positive.
What about John and Michael?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Donna, I can't rule out one of them without that information.
But I can't just ask Michael. I mean, what am I going to say when he wants to know why?
What about your mother-in-law? He said that you were going over there for a visit.
That's right.
Well, I mean, sometimes parents keep medical records of their children around. You might ask.
No, I don't even have to. You see, she keeps everything upstairs in John and Michael's old bedroom.
Medical record?
No, dog tags from the war. Well, I've already seen John's. I know it had his blood type on it, but I was just so shaken when I saw it. I can't remember it now.
Right.
But that means Michael's have to be there, too.
Yes.
And then I could remember.
Yes, you know, that sounds perfect. I'll see you then.
Yes, good.
So thank you very, very much, Mitch.
What, do you have some news? I mean, have you located John?
No, but I think we're hot on his trail. Look, I'll talk to you later.
I'm here.
Great.
Right.
Well, thanks, Doc.
Take care.
We'll see you.
Right. Donna, we'll speak again.
Yes.
You're here to see Felicia?
Yes. As a matter of fact.
Mitch.
Hello, Alan.
Hello, Felicia. Don't you look sensational?
Why, thank you. You don't look so bad yourself.
You think?
Mm-hmm.
Well, where would you think us beautiful people ought to go?
What exactly did you have in mind?
How much exactly do you want to know?
Well...
Excuse me, please.
No, Mitch, I want to talk to you about something, all right?
Oh, I've come to bed.
No, you haven't. Listen, Sarah? I'll have Sarah seat you. Honey, would you be kind enough to show Dr. Blaser to a nice table?
Right this way.
All right, I want to hear all about the special things you have planned for the evening.
Sure.
Great.
Don't hurry your business.
No, thank you. Thank you.
Ask him if he wears socks.
Very funny.
Ask him if he wears socks to bed. He's got a bed.
Would you be serious? Listen, I followed your mystery lady.
Where?
Into the powder room. Now, she's not using the phone that you've tapped. She's using the payphone in the powder room. She called the operator overseas, couldn't get through, and said she would call back.
I already know that.
I'm really sorry about what happened in Colorado.
Don't have to say that.
No, I mean it, Scott. I should never let Pops come between us. But I promise you, it'll never happen again.
You sure about this?
We're right for each other. We belong together.
That's the way I feel, too. Just after this killer's come after you like this, we have to be really careful.
I know that, Scott. I know that. But you know what? I was thinking, next week, we have a week off for Easter vacation. Mm. I want you to take me away.
What, just you and me?
Yeah. To someplace far away and safe.
Oh.
You know, someplace where we can just be alone. The two of us. Where we can love each other.
That sounds great, but I just don't know if it's the right idea. Right now.
Why not?
I kind of want to put you in any danger.
I told you, Scott, we'll go away.
I know, but the guy could be watching you, and I don't want him to think we're back together yet.
Look, I thought about that, and I came up with an idea of a way to fool him.
How?
We'll make it look like we're going away with a whole bunch of friends, like maybe a class trip or something, and he'll never know it'll just be the two of us.
I don't know, Cheryl. It doesn't seem like the right thing.
Scott, I want us to be together. Now, this is our only chance. It's our only vacation until summer.
What about Vince? What are you going to tell him?
What I should have told him in Colorado.
He's not exactly going to give you his blessing yet.
I'm not asking for his permission. I just want him to understand what we feel.
Understanding is one thing. Accepting is another.
Pop is just going to have to deal with that on his own.
You sure you want to do this?
Mm-hmm. I want to. For us.
Okay, well, what time are you going to go talk to Vince?
I don't know. As soon as I can get him alone, I guess.
You want me to go with you?
No. No, this is something I have to do on my own. I think it's going to be the hardest thing I've ever had to do in my life.
Michael ever tell you he used to sit here just like this, Saturday nights after the game?
No, he never told me that.
No, I never told her that, Mom. Thanks. No, actually, I used to come home after the basketball game and help Mom with the knitting, and the kids used to give me a real hard time about it.
Your brother John gave you the hardest time of all.
My brother John. John gave me knitting needles for Christmas one year. I nearly handed him his head.
The fights these two used to get into used to be like two dogs after a bone.
Wait a minute here. Now, I never started those fights.
Oh, you started your share. But in the end, you were always first to reach out. You were always there for John.
Well, at least I know there was a lot of love in this house.
Oh, that was the one thing we were never short of, right, Michael?
You bet, Ma.
Hey.
Right. A lot of love. You know, Ma, it's great to be in here with family, you know.
That's what I keep saying.
Ma, Donna and I were thinking that maybe you'd like to come and live with us.
Yes, we have plenty of room.
What? Leave the farm?
Well, you wouldn't have to leave the farm. You'd just come and live with us. You'd come back and visit, you know. You just wouldn't have to work so hard. All I'm thinking is that you're not getting any younger.
There's a few good kicks left in me still.
I know, but I'd like you to just be at my house where I could look after you.
God, a nurse to look after me.
Ma, you're my family. I'd love us all to be under the same roof.
This is my home. Your father brought me here as a bride, and I don't figure on leaving it till they cart me off in a wooden box.
Told you she was stubborn.
Look, Clara. Michael really just wants us to be together as a family. And I really would love it if you would think about moving into our home.
Oh, honey. When you get to be my age and you live in a house as long as I have, well, it gets so the both of you start creaking at the same time and in the same place. No, I could never think of giving this place up. It'd be like giving away one of my children. No, I'm fine right here.
Ma, hey, come on now. Look, who you've got to talk to around this house? Just that nurse.
All I have to do is pick up the phone and call you if I get lonesome.
Well, I'm going to be traveling a lot. That's why I,
Where are you going?
Well, business. Business, that's all. Just business.
No, you're not going on business. You're going to look for John, aren't you? Well, it's about time you came around.
Look, I did not
you
say
know,
that.
I've been getting hoarse telling him over and over again that his brother's alive.
We have no proof of that.
Don't you play fast and loose with me, Michael Hudson. The truth is going to have to come out anyway, so you might as well tell me now.
Mom, there's nothing to tell you.
You know, I always knew when you were trying to get one by me, and that's exactly what you're doing now.
Mom, I'm not trying.
Where is he, Michael? Where's John?
Pops, I need to talk to you. It's really important.
I am going to be here all night. First, you go cooperate with the police.
But you don't understand.
Girl, come on. Come talk to me in the kitchen. It'll only take a minute, I promise.
Go. Mm-hmm. We'll talk later.
Okay, what's this about, MJ? I already told the police everything I know.
Well, Adam has a theory about the stalker, and he asked me to ask you some questions, okay?
Okay. In fact, I wanted to talk to you about something.
You did? What?
Back in Colorado, Scott and I wanted to make a commitment together.
What do you mean, a commitment?
You know, MJ, I haven't been with a man before, and I let Pops talk me out of it, even though I knew deep in my heart that it was right for Scott and me.
So have you given this a lot of thought?
Yeah. Scott and I are going away for Easter vacation. We're going to sleep together.
That's kind of what I wanted to talk to
MJ,
you about.
MJ, we've already made a decision.
Just hold on a second. You know, like I said, Adam has this theory about the stalker.
MJ, I don't want to talk about it.
Will you listen to me for a second, please? He thinks that the reason this guy gave you a warning is because he wants you to stay pure.
What?
Adam thinks that if you and Scott sleep together right now, you could be putting yourself in danger. I mean, think about it. This guy is watching you. He could be listening to us right now.
Don't you think I know that? In fact, that's what Scott said from the very beginning.
Well, so then you can see that this is the worst possible time for the two of you to be together.
MJ, there is no other time that Scott and I are going to have off. Besides, we're taking precautions.
Cheryl, the guy is a murderer. He's killed a lot of women. Oh, he's giving you a warning.
I don't need any lectures, MJ. I need your help. Now, are you going to be a cop or are you going to be my sister?
Hi, Rachel.
I hope I'm not early.
Rachel, we were supposed to have cocktails, right?
Yes, if this isn't a good time, we can drink it.
No. In fact, look, why don't you sit down right here, make yourself comfortable. I just have a few things to take care of, all right?
Yes,
I'll be right back. Please. How did you know that your mystery woman, what's her name anyway?
Elizabeth,
how cute. How did you know that she was making phone calls from the ladies' room?
I've got my ways, okay?
You got 5 seconds, mister.
She can be a real pain.
Would
you
just tell me, please? Come on.
It's very simple. She asked me for some change. I put two and two together, and then I took out some insurance.
What kind of insurance?
The kind that lights up when the phone in the ladies' powder room is used.
What's that mean?
This is called a dead phone.
Right.
You can listen, but you can't talk into it.
You mean every time somebody makes a call from the ladies' room, this little button lights up?
Bright red.
Oh, that's brilliant. Really?
Why don't you just let me take care of the phone, and you take care of your date?
Alan, I forgot all about Alan. Yeah, go. Alan, I am so sorry.
Oh,
really,
oh,
I am.
Listen, I think I've caught you on a bad night.
Well, yeah, Dad's gotten a little busy here. Thank you.
Why don't we reserve tomorrow night just for the two of us?
You know, that would be better. Thank you.
I thought we might do something kind of special.
Well, I hope you're not going to keep me in suspense.
Oh, well, I hear there's a new dinner cruise that sails between Bay City and Chicago.
Oh, I've heard about that. It's supposedly very très chic and spa.
Yeah, a week. Yes. Oh, it's dining and dancing, and they say the view of the skyline is absolutely spectacular.
Well, it sounds incredible.
You're incredible. So how about it? Dining and dancing under the stars tomorrow night?
I can't wait.
I know I haven't been going out with anyone. I can't believe I'm getting a lecture about men from my very own mother.
Well, I'm really looking forward to it, Alan.
Good. I'll pick you up around 7.
7 is perfect. Listen, would you mind if I invited Rachel Corey to have a drink with us?
No, no, not at all.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Right.
What's happening with the hotline?
In the deep freeze right now.
Mitch, there's some action.
Leave it alone. I'll take care of it.
Come on, Jamie. Tell me where we're going.
You're the psychic.
You're not going to give me a clue, are you?
Well, let's just say that tonight's going to be the most perfect date you've ever been on.
Sweet.
I told you to leave it alone.
It was only Lisa. Jamie's got something planned tonight. I'd love to know what it is.
Look, you ought to stay out of this. This is none of your business. Don't do that.
Well, excuse me. I forgot who I was talking to. I would love to play Cupid for those two.
Michelle, I would like to help you, but I'm afraid for you.
Don't be, MJ. Look, this isn't easy for me. I thought... maybe you've been through this yourself, and maybe you could help.
But I wasn't in danger, and you are.
This is scary enough, MJ, please.
Okay, honey.
Right.
I want to be there for you, no matter what.
I just wish I'd had somebody to talk to back then.
You didn't have anybody to talk to?
Not really.
And it made everything harder,
I know.
And what did you tell Pop?
I didn't tell Pop that. Thing. For one thing, I was in Chicago.
Another thing, Pops and I didn't have such a great relationship when I was your age. You know, I want you to know, I really admire you for wanting to be upfront with him. It takes a lot of maturity. It's not too smart, but it's very mature.
I'm afraid Pops and I won't be on talking terms.
No. Pops may not agree with you, but I think he'll respect you for being honest with him. Anyway, he has got to realize you're an adult now. He can't run your life.
I don't want to hurt him, MJ.
Don't worry about Pops. Pops is tough. He can take it. He just don't learn to let go.
What is it?
Oh,
I was just wondering, what was it like your first time?
My first time. Well, I had just moved to Chicago to make it on my own, you know. And I met this man who I really loved a lot. At least I thought I did anyway, who knows. And he was kind and gentle. Suddenly I just knew it was the right time.
You weren't nervous?
I was petrified. I don't know. You know what? It was beautiful. It was perfect. Afterwards, I really kind of wondered why I had been so afraid.
You didn't feel awkward because you were so inexperienced.
Oh, yeah. Of course I did. But he was very patient and loving. He cared about me a whole lot. Exactly the way Scott cares about you, which is why I don't think you've got anything to worry about.
But MJ, Scott has so much experience. I don't want to disappoint him.
Are you crazy? Cheryl, if Scott loves you half as much as I think he does, it's going to be wonderful. It's going to be great because you guys love each other so much. So will you just stop worrying?
Okay. Now I'm really glad we talked about this.
Me too. I guess everybody needs someone to talk to sometimes.
Oh, Jane.
I need your help.
No, only if you tell me what you're planning for Lisa tonight.
I've been researching your novels.
Oh, I'm so flattered, really.
Yes. Remember the one, Love Beneath the Stars.
Right.
Seen on page 42?
Is that the one where Preston surprises Olivia with a...
Yes.
Oh, that's perfect.
But it's got to be just the way it was in the book on page 42.
The whole page?
Really?
Well, yeah, I can write him and you can live him. All right, now, here comes, page 42. When you see it in living color, you'll love it.
Do you think she'll like it?
Oh, yes, Lisa's gonna...
Lisa will what?
Lisa! We were just talking about
it. We were.
Okay, so what's going on?
My lips are sealed.
Yeah.
Any news?
This isn't working. I can't keep listening to everybody's conversation.
I can do it.
I'm going to take care of this personally. You keep your paws off the phone. Hello there.
Well, I was wondering when you were going to come over.
It's been busy.
Yeah, I noticed. Would you like to join me for a drink?
Actually, I would, but unfortunately, I've got to say goodbye.
Oh, are you getting off work so soon?
Well, I'm going on a trip, sort of a business trip.
And don't tell me you're a traveling bartender.
Actually, I'm going along to help out a friend.
Must be a very good friend.
Well, it's a very rich friend. Michael Hudson.
I see. How long will you be gone?
Well, it depends on how soon we find what we're looking for.
So you would rather be treasure hunting with Michael Hudson?
Well, we're looking for his brother, and we think we've found him, but he's not nearby.
No? Where is he?
Well, we've traced him to Key West. So we need to get there before we miss him.
Well, that's a shame. I was hoping we could get better acquainted.
Well, I would have liked that. But maybe next time.
Maybe.
I'll see you then.
Sorry.
Oh, thank you.
Are you all right?
You're off.
No, I know. Let's just... you're going. I'll be right back, I promise. What is it?
I want to place a call to Singapore.
Bingo.
Mom, if I had any concrete news about John, I would tell you.
No, you wouldn't. You'd be afraid that I'd get my hopes up.
Look, would you just stop doing this to yourself?
I will not stop until my son is home where he belongs.
Don't expect miracles. And that's all I'm going to say to you.
Look, I think I'm going to go upstairs. There's some pictures up there that I wanted to get.
You go right ahead, dear.
All right.
Can I help you?
No. I know where they are. Listen, why don't you just stay down here with your mother?
Even Donna can't bear to stay in the room listening to you lie to me. You know as well as I do that John is alive. Don't understand it. Why hasn't he contacted us? Do you think he could be hurt bad? Or maybe sick?
I don't know, Mom. I wish I did.
Well, you've got to find out, Michael. I mean, we can't let any more time pass by.
Mom,
Every minute is precious.
Stop getting so excited, all right? All the stress is not good for you.
I am not going to my grave without seeing John. There's too much left unresolved. I will never find any peace till I see my boy.
The next part of Another World.
Donna.
Dr. Glaser, you're not going to believe this.
No, just take it easy, Donna. What's wrong?
I found Michael and John's dog tags. And they both have the same blood type. B positive. Now, look, I know what you're going to say.
I'm sorry, Donna, but either one of them could be the father of the twins.
Other way I can tell?
The only other way is to run a cell test.
Can you do that?
It depends. You've got to be able to find John. You've got to hope that he's alive and willing to take the test. That's the only way you're ever going to be sure.
I see. All right, well, thank you.
Donna? Ready to go?
Secrets.
No, I don't believe that.
Come on, Jamie, tell me what you're planning.
All I'll say is the setting's going to be perfect. And I guarantee there won't be any interruptions.
Sounds like you went through a lot of trouble for this.
Well, it's all going to be worth it. We're finally going to have a chance to get to know each other.
Well, what if we don't like what we see?
Hey, I'm a great guy. Ask my mother.
I think I know what she would say.
Okay, well then, ask Felicia. She's got great taste.
What does my aunt have to do with this anyway?
What did they say? When did you arrive in Singapore?
Just a few hours ago. I'm waiting for Jerry Haupt to make contact.
Where's he coming in from?
Honolulu via the scenic route. Wake Island, Guam, Borneo, Manila, and finally Singapore.
Well, you can tell him to relax. No one will be following him.
Are you certain?
Quite. Michael Hudson will be searching for his brother in Key West, Florida.
It's still best not to take any chances.
As you wish.
When our Mr. Halk arrives,
I think we'll have him change his name again and go underground just for a while, just in case. There must be no margin for error. Michael Hudson must not get anywhere near his brother.
Mom, just listen to me. You lost John once. I know what you went through, and I am not going to put you through that again.
I found the pictures that I wanted. I'm going to have these copied, and then we can put them in a frame.
You're taking those pictures to help you find John, aren't you?
You listen to me. If John is alive, then nothing and no one will keep me from bringing him home, okay?
Clara, there is nothing we want more than to find John alive. And you have to know that I want all of us to be together as family, just as much as you do.
Thank you, Donna. It's time for your nap, Mrs. Hudson. She thinks I have nothing better to do than sleep.
Sleep well, Ma.
I'll be waiting to hear from you.
Donna, I hate not being able to love a woman like that.
Then why didn't you just tell her the truth?
What's the truth, Donna? The truth that my brother is probably alive? Or that if he is alive, he's hiding from his own family?
Well, she's going to have to face that someday.
No, but she's not going to face it until I know for sure I can bring John back here. Until then, she's not going to hear a word about him from me. I just don't understand, though. What could be so bad that it's kept John from us for all these years? What?
Pops, I need to talk to you.
Okay, what's up?
No, alone.
Oh, serious, huh?
Yeah. Why don't we go upstairs?
Okay.
Okay, let's go.
What was that all about?
Fasten your seatbelt. It's gonna be a bumpy night.
I need to talk to you.
Look like you missed the bed.
I've been trailing Carlisle for the last 24 hours.
I thought I told you to keep your nose out of this case.
Did you check out on the supply store? I'm telling you, Tony Carlisle bought ink pads there. Right? He's probably now stamping out a message for his next victim right now.
I told you I'd check it out, all right?
Nancy could be attacked again. You want that on your conscience?
Look, don't bother yourself with it.
But the guy's a killer, all right?
Butt out of this case, or you're going to be the next one to be arrested.
But I don't care what you do to me, all right? I don't care. I care about Nancy right now. She's with a maniac. We got to get away from there.
Have you forgotten that you're a suspect in this case?
Come on.
As a matter of fact, if I were you, I'd call your lawyer. Something going to bring you back in for questioning.
Before?
Whoever got Cheryl down to that gazebo had to have been a pretty bright guy, so I'd be real interested to know what a genius like yourself had to say about
that. You guys are pathetic. You know that? You go ahead and hang out here and waste time. I'll find the killer myself.
Won't you sit down?
That's serious, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me have it. All right.
Pop, I'm not a little girl anymore.
Yeah, I can see that.
I mean, I don't want to be treated as one. I'm an adult. And I want to be treated as one.
Oh, you say I've been a little too overbearing, a little too overprotecting, huh?
Mm-hmm. But I understand. But I have to be able to make my own decisions.
Well, sure. Up to a point, that's very reasonable. But...
Pops, please listen to me.
I've decided that I'm in love with Scott.
Honey, I know
Will
that.
Will you listen to me, Pop? I've decided that I want to be with Scott.
Cheryl, hey, sweetheart, we've already talked about this.
No, Pop. You've talked. I've listened. Now it's my turn.
Go ahead.
Okay. Now, MJ and Kathleen both made love to men before they were married, and it worked out okay. Look, I know this is really hard for you, Pop, because I'm the youngest, and I've always been your little girl. But I'm not a little girl anymore, Pop. I'm an adult.
I can't tell you what to do. All I can do is, you know, give you advice.
Look, Pop, you gave me advice, and I listened to it. And I thought a lot about it. But it's not right for me, Pop. Not that there's anything wrong with it. It's just not right for me.
Can I ask you a couple of questions?
Sure.
You sure that Scott's the right guy? And that he really loves you?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Uh-huh. And he'll take care of you and he'll be concerned with your safety?
Of course, Pop. No. I trusted him when you didn't, and he saved your life. I know he'd do the same for me.
I just don't want you to get hurt.
Scott and I are going away. Some place where the Sims doctor will never find us.
What happens when you come back?
I don't know. We'll deal with it then, Pop. Look, I'm not asking for your permission. I just wanted you to know how I felt.
Well, sounds like you've already, you know, made up your mind.
You know, Pop, it's not going to be so bad. You may have to say goodbye to your little girl, but you get to say hello to a brand new young woman.
Everything's all set.
Everything's set?
Oh. Are you ready for Key West?
Key West?
Yeah, if we get a move on it, we can be there before John knows that we're on his trail.
It's great.
It's great.
Yeah, but Michael, I...
Really?
Oh, of course. I'll pack an overnight bag.
Now, you want to tell me what's going on?
You really didn't trace John to Key West, did you?
No, it was Singapore, but as soon as I let it out to her mystery woman that we were going to go to Florida, she goes and calls the fat man.
Who's in Singapore?
Waiting for Jerry Hopp.
Great. Look, I'm going to go fuel on my jet.
I'll get my stuff.
No, you stay here, all right? You make sure that she's been thrown off the trail and then grab a commercial flight tomorrow.
Okay, I'll do that and I'll meet you there.
Great.
And don't you even say it. I am coming with you.
Now, you're absolutely certain we're going to have a good time tonight.
You know something I don't know?
Well, I was starting to get an impression.
No. Don't you dare.
You two have a good time.
I must be the only one in Bay City who doesn't know what you have planned tonight.
We'll just strap him down so he won't run off to the hospital.
Hey.
All right. It's about that time.
What time?
For the real-life romance to begin. Follow me.
I I don't believe this.
Jamie planned the whole thing.
All for you, mademoiselle. A very special night. Oh, that's very pretty.
Well, I did it.
It's like a dream.
I love you so much.
Oh, I love you. I love you.
But we gotta be careful. We can't let anybody know about this.
Hey, nobody is going to hurt you, okay? I promise you.
Blackie.
No, you know our love is too precious. Now, please don't ask me to stay behind.
Donna, you know I don't want to put you in any kind of danger ever again.
The only danger is in us being separated.
No.
Please.
You know when you do that, I can't say no to you.
Good, I knew you wouldn't leave me behind.
Okay. You can go to Singapore with me. Who knows? Maybe we will find John. Maybe we will be a family again.
This part of Another World was brought to you by Dawn, the dishwashing liquid that does more than just cut grease. Dawn takes grease out of your way. Tonight on Highway to Heaven, Jonathan and Mark discover a pesky old dog who holds the key to finding a father and son injured in an auto wreck. Then the inspiring epic concludes, Jesus of Nazareth, the eternal story of love, faith, and passion, featuring one of the greatest casts ever assembled in the greatest story ever told. You look